Okay, let us solve a small problem on current assets and liquid assets. As I told you earlier that the formula of current ratio is current assets divided by current liabilities. Okay, yes, from the following information calculate current ratio and liquid ratio. Yes, these are the current assets and current liabilities of the organization. Please watch carefully. Stock, debtors, cash, bank, bills receivable, interest receivable and prepaid expenses. They are all current assets. Okay, next one, debentures. No, this is not current asset. This is long term liability, right? And provision for taxation is also current liability, not current asset. This is current liability. Next, let us see what are current liabilities. Provision for taxation, creditors and bills payable. Okay, yes. Now let us see what are the current assets of the organization. As I told you that the formula of current ratio is current assets divided by current liabilities. Yes, they are all current assets of the organization. Bills receivable plus debtors plus cash plus bank plus interest receivable plus prepaid expenses. The total current assets amounts to rupees 2 lakhs. Okay. Next, current liabilities. Creditors 70,000, right? Then bills payable 24,000. Then, yeah, provision for taxation 6,000. The total current liabilities amounts to rupees 1 lakh. Now, you apply the formula. Current ratio is equal to current assets divided by current liabilities. Current assets is 2 lakhs, whereas current liability is 1 lakh. When you divide the 2 lakhs by 1 lakh, you get 2:1. 2:1. Right? Similarly, the standard ratio, standard current ratio is 2:1. Here in our problem, current ratio is 2:1. This is exactly equal to the standard ratio. It means the company is able to meet its short-term obligations very easily. The company's short-term solvency is strong. Next, asset test ratio or quick ratio. Yes, the formula is liquid ratio is equal to quick assets divided by quick liabilities. See, which are quick assets? Right, all items except stock and which is another one. Yeah, stock is not included. Yes, inventory is not included. You see? Yes. This 60,000 is what? You see? Where is 60,000?
First one, stock. Stocks.
Where is stock?
First one.
Yeah. Exclude stock. Then second one is 1,000. That is, yeah, prepaid expenses and right interest receivable. These are the items which are excluded from the current assets. Okay, when you deduct all these items from the current assets, we get 1,39,000. Similarly, quick liabilities, liquid liabilities. Now, two items. One is bank overdraft is excluded from this. Okay, here in our problem, there is no bank overdraft. Then the quick liability comes to rupees 1 lakh. Divide 1,39,000 by 1 lakh, we get 1.39:1. Our standard quick ratio is standard ratio is 1:1, whereas the actual quick ratio of this organization is 1.39:1. So that this indicates the financial strength of the organization. I hope you understand the calculation of current ratio and liquid ratio.